Hello everybody, feel warmly welcome to Usitility. Today is special, we are on the way to discover how to launch and play Solar Smash on your PC. From now you are able to display it on your screen. It will be possible to easily download and set up Solar Smash so that we can play the game on a Windows computer with keyboard, mouse and large monitor. Then it's time to have fun, let's get to it. First of all buddies, the first thing to do is to launch our main browser. We open the one we use by default. Let's go to the current URL I have highlighted in green color. Now, you are able to discover on the PC screen. There is no need to type this URL, simply because there's the clickable link in the video description and as well in the first main comment. We landed right here on our Usitility website, where we have an in-depth summary on just how to download and install Solar Smash on computer. We scroll down a bit as well as click the Download Game on PC button. Once clicking on this link, we arrive here on the site of LDPlayer. No panic, it is simply the Android emulator that we are going to run to play Solar Smash on our PC. As you can see from here, we access a great deal of pros of using that emulator, custom controls, multiple instances, instant synchronization, macros, scripts, high FPS, etc. Then, we are ready to start downloading the Solar Smash by simply clicking on this button Download Solar Smash on PC that I have marked in green color. The step is clicking on that button. And the download step takes no time at all. Voila, here is located the download. It is a file we have to execute. The following step is to run the executable file, okay, then we click on this file. If we are on Windows 10, it will have asked us for permission to allow modifications to the system. We have clicked yes. I reduce the internet browser to find the installation software considerably better. The installer is really straightforward. It contains two possibilities, install and setup path. I will talk about what setup path actually does. We only click it. And now we note that we end up with here the path in which the emulator can be set up. If we plan to change for better this folder, we have to click on that browse option, and therefore we decide on another directory and set up the emulator precisely where we prefer. To keep it simple, just keep it as it is. Then, I click on back. So I just click install. At this point, prior to starting installing that emulator, will also be possible that it's going to suggest us one or two application deals to put on the computer. Because I do not want any of those software programs, I purely click many times on the reject option. Voila! The setup begins and it's going to progress in the download of all these MB which are presented on our computer screen. At the time you save it on your computer, it may be slightly more or less MB. The download rate may go at a higher speed or at a lower speed, depending on your connection and according to the efficiency of the emulator hosting servers. Right now they're working super fast. The download has been completed, then right now it continues with the setup procedure. The setup needs a little bit more or less time according to the strength of your machine. The more robust it actually is, the shorter the software setup time and or vice versa. If we put together the download and installation step, it will take quite a long time, so have patience. It is now completely finished on my side. At this point, the emulator happens to be started immediately. As you will notice, at the bottom of the screen, there's a progress bar which will move forward to the right, and once it gets into the ending, the emulator can be launched for the first time. The fact is the emulator has been started, here for the very first time. Plus LD Store is instantly started, that is a sort of Google Play. It isn't really the best option to set up the game, and so I really don't propose it, considering that sometimes the LD Store puts an out-of-date version of the Android game. I'll explain the best way to install the video game by utilizing the Google Play, therefore I recommend you to do it this way. First of all, we have to accomplish is to head to the computer's desktop by pressing the software icon that I'm indicating in green. Before we carry on, as you will notice, it has made two app icons there on the computer desktop. The LDPlayer and LD Multiplayer. Note that the LDPlayer app icon is definitely the one we're concerned about. Each time we have to run Solar Smash on the desktop or laptop, we twice click on the specific software icon and start the emulator. The LD Multiplayer icon has nothing to do with multiplayer or even nearly anything such as that. Of course, it's an app icon that we would certainly never ever work with. We should conduct the following step, which is actually a must-have, and this is to begin to browse the Google Play Store. To do that we will browse there to, System Apps, we click on. And we'll just click on Play Store. As you can see now the Google Play is started. Right here we must log on. At this time once we're right here, we must absolutely execute this next phase that is compulsory. Therefore mouse click on, Sign In. At this point it shows, Checking Info. It could in some cases get stopped at checking info, that's why it isn't going to proceed. If that's the case, you may attempt to connect to your account after a number of hours, it's going to very likely be corrected. At this point, we're going to insert our email and password. The email address is required to be a Gmail email as well as its related password. As an example, you make use of the very same email address you are using at this moment in your own YouTube account. So that I am going to type my info and I will return after I have accomplished it. That's all, info typed in. Below is Google welcoming us and presenting us their twos. We would approve all of them by just clicking, I agree. After that, it make us possible to save to the Google Cloud. You might keep it selected, it's going to generate a backup of the data files on that device to Google Drive. I will not select it, you can utilize this option if you wish. We mouse click on accept. From now Google Play is started as preferred choice and immediately. However, if the Google Play is simply not presented by default and you have no idea how to run it by yourself, I guide you towards how to achieve it. Firstly is to go to the emulator desktop by simply clicking on this app icon designated in green. At present we head to the system apps folder. And we click the Play Store icon. Fine, we are right here inside of Google Play. What we intend to perform right now is browse here to search for apps and games. And consequently we're going to do a search for Solar Smash. Furthermore, there we have got it, we must choose the first result. Right here we have got the game app. Let's quickly mouse click now on the install link that I'm just showing now in green. Therefore, it will commence the software installation. At this time it is going to download and install the Android game, it could take a little while or perhaps it may possibly be very quick. That all depends on our own connection to the web. It's already completed setting up. Back to the emulator desktop by clicking this particular option I'm emphasizing in green, that allows you to use Solar Smash for the first time. We're now on the emulator desktop, and then we're on the way to just click the fresh Solar Smash app icon which has been provided. This game app is started for the first time. Here we end up with it, I can also mouse click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I should discuss the volume level of this emulator. This is right here, we use the icon of higher volume along with the icon of lower volume, this manner we are not going to use the Microsoft Windows volume to increase or decrease the music of this emulator. As well as to take pleasure in the experience to the maximum, we should activate the large monitor, for which we have two alternatives. That is actually the first one, we mouse click on that app icon which I'm identifying in green. Then the monitor is maximized, offering one border on top, one on the right side and the third one at the bottom. Assuming that we need to have fun with the app using all the screen, we select that software icon. And we might at present be experiencing the gameplay in 100% screen function. To escape the 100% screen setting, just click the F11 key. And we'd now end up being in standard display screen setting. At this moment I am choosing to demonstrate to you the keys mapping and that is certainly rather useful. That means we definitely will be ready to make use of the game app more effortlessly. The very first point is to click on this app icon. It's now time to get the appropriate setups. I'll go ahead and put the normal settings, however if you intend to improve that, you may well do it without having problem. I just take this occasion to say that in certain cases, when launching the game application a dark screen occurs, if it is so and you get the black display and this emulator fails to start, I suggest a plausible fix. We should click here, to the cogwheel. Within the emulator preferences, in the advanced choice we have got quite a lot of screen resolutions. The following is the image resolution we have at the moment opted for automatically, therefore we must select any of these other screen resolutions, for instance that one below. We pick it and next mouse click save. It will probably tell us to reboot your emulator and right after restarted, likely the emulator will start up and that black display will disappear. Obviously, the emulator is entirely in our own language. In certain cases it occurs that your emulator is presented in the erroneous language, for instance, in Chinese language. Then to place it in the proper language we click here to the cogwheel. Then there inside of various other configuration settings, we just click the language drop down. We may very well determine the language we prefer, Spanish, Mandarin, and so forth. After the language is decided, we would save, the emulator will reboot, and also the game, next time we start it, would as well be in the specified language. At present, you can find another information that we need to take into consideration, and this is that we will get a message from Google telling that a brand new electronic device has been connected with our own Google account. It definitely will ask us if we're the people who have associated with that device. Absolutely, we ought not worry, as the emulator is acting as an Google Android smartphone or tablet. And then to find which smartphone or tablet is currently being emulated, we come back right here, to the cogwheel and we then click on it. And so we browse here to the model choice. And there we realize that the emulator is simulating a Samsung mobile. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. That's all guys, so much for that video tutorial. I hope that you appreciated it, specifically that everyone thought it was handy. If that is so, bring it a nice thumb up, subscribe, and any remarks, issues or suggestions, let them in the comment field below. You also can leave comments on my Twitch channel, I actually do live streams occasionally, you get it listed below in the video description and in the first pinned comment. Click on any of those videos which are usually appearing on the screen and see you in the next training videos. Bye.